supervision. I repeat, specific po yun. It is not an MA in RE. It is MA in Catechetical Leadership and Supervision. Those who will enter the program, who are willing to get a 6 units, must undergo at least assessment. Assessment meaning they may have to submit a project paper, a program of catechesis in the diocese. So that is graded. Precisely because kung 6 units ang in-earn, you need to at least submit a paper to qualify for the MA program. Hopefully, yun nga binigay ko sa inyong dates, hopefully the dates for next year would be May 8 to 19. May 8 to 19 at the De La Salle University campus in Taft Avenue. The reason, I repeat, May 8 to May 19, 2017. So, isang tao po yun, because the TWG, our group, will be the ones to teach because we have our own specific specialization. We're still finalizing the curriculum of studies for the 14 days. Actually, this is analogous to what we did at SEA when we offered their certificate in Catholic School Leadership. It's a 14-day program for directors of schools, superintendents of schools, principals, and the 14 days are focused on curriculum design, financial management, legal management. At the same token, let's offer the same kind of program to our catechetical directors. This is our move to professionalize the management of catechetical offices in dioceses. So hopefully, brothers, that's May 8 to May 19. Right? Topics would be curriculum design. The topics would be under the heading of Being, Knowing, and Doing, the tripod of the General Directory for Catechesis. That was our discussion last night. So, the framework of the 14 days would be the GDC, or the General Directory for Catechesis. In other words, isang pare, pag pumasok doon at the end of 14 days, would go home with at least enough knowledge, know-how, and skills to manage a catechetical office. Because a good number of us are really MAs in theology, not catechesis. How do we speak the language of catechesis? How do we mobilize, and this is a big issue, no? How do we mobilize 99% of our catechesis who are volunteer, retired, in their own respective jobs? How do you raise funds, capacity building? How do you do resource mobilization? How do you do financial management in a catechetical office with bigger resources? You try to play around those things. If you have some suggestions, we'll do that in a little while. All right? I'll go back to that topic again. So that to draw out from you concerns that you may want the 14 days to be as effective and as relevant and responsive to your needs. That's the first. Also, we would want to teach in the 14 days the K-12 program. Why? The reason is because as catechetical directors, we're facing the public schools, and the public schools are offering grades 11 and 12. What then is the new curriculum for the public schools? That's a big issue, precisely because wala pa tayong targets of learning sa grades 11 and 12. But this year, we're offering grade 11 in the schools, both public and private. That is why I would want to raise the issue that even in Catholic schools, the ECHE, or at least this body of catechetical directors, should provide direction on what should be the learning targets in catechesis or religious ed in grades 11 and 12. In other words, anong ituturo sa 11 and 12? Should we provide models? Models, in other words, this model is grade 11 would be commitment, choices, and vocation, discernment. Another one would be social teachings of the church, management, and ethics. Why? Because they will go into the workforce. Should that be the topic that we would provide our young people in grades 11 and 12, considering that it is called senior high school and junior high school all wrapped into one? Okay, kailangan po natin iyon. Kasi nakalagay yun sa Article 14 ng Philippine Constitution at the option of parents, catechesis, or religious instruction should be taught at the regular school hours. And in the new curriculum of grades 11 and 12, there is an area there which is values education or philosophy choices. So, wala pang direction doon. We really have to discuss that, fathers. The other one is, how do we do catechesis for adults? Reason is because majority of our catechists know how to teach children. And when they do catechesis for adults, they treat the adults like children. In other words, the pedagogy for adult catechesis is different from the pedagogy done to children. So, I think we also need to learn the ropes. We should not leave it simply to catechists to devise their own methodology. But the priest director should know methods, pedagogy, skills, classroom management. All of these areas, I suggest, should be included in the 14 days next year. The other one is the agenda of Pope Francis in Evangelii Gaudium, which is mystagogical catechesis. This is one thing that is lacking in the church in our country. And that is, we have a strong pre-sacramental catechesis, give or take, but we hardly have any follow-up after the sacramental encounter. Mystagogical catechesis is lifelong learning encounter with Jesus Christ in the church. So one of the things that I would suggest is that we study also the ropes of mystagogical catechesis. Particularly slowly, there are some adult RCIA during the Easter Vigil that we do not simply indulge them into one catechesis and then we give them baptism, confirmation, Eucharist. There is what we call in the church, which all of us learned in the seminary, the RCIA, the Rite of Christian Initiation for Adults, that begins on Ash Wednesday and ends in Easter Vigil with their baptism, confirmation, Eucharist. But Pope Francis is saying, what happens after that encounter with the Lord? You have these adults, new Christians, initiated into the Christian mysteries. Mystagogical catechesis is addressing that need. Should we offer a model of adult catechesis? In fact, in the parish of Father Dex and I, we have this year the initial RCIA. It was wonderful. I had 5 baptisms. But we started with 6 weeks of intensive catechesis and the rituals of RCIA. Still raw, still to be developed, but at least we started. But one thing, in the rite itself, there is what we call the oil of catechumens. When I was asking Father Jenny why we have an oil, he said, no, the bishops decided not to have any more blessing of oil for catechumens, only for chrism and sick. But initially, if we are strict with the rites, there should be 3 oils that are blessed during chrism mass. One of them is really the oil for catechumens, which is done at the initial phase of their entry into the church. That's all catechesis. That's all our work. There, we work closely with the liturgical office so that liturgy and catechesis work together for the program of lifelong learning. Okay, that's the first. Okay, I'll stop there. Any questions so far? Yung ladderized program towards MA. Pwede rin naman na aralin lang ng pare 14 days. You don't have to go for MA. So we collapse all the topics 14 days. Yes, Father?
Finances, Father. Finances.
Finances, Lasal, thanks be to God, will provide financial support for that. It won't be the rate of DLSU. No, we have not worked that out, but certainly we will try to bring down the cost as possible because we know the capacity of the catechetical offices. But thank you for that. Yes, Father?
I'm requesting the office to invite the bishop to be awareness of this program so that
we will, I think.
We could bring the place to restrict or that
perhaps Bishop Bobet can make that announcement. But you would want to finish the program first. Maybe the program can be finished and distributed to the bishops in the January meeting to early ng Mandala ng Rulani. So maybe January. Yes, Father?
Sir, it is a laudable initiative on the part of NCHEC. But how at least more or less, COPAS would be the cost for each participant? But it's more or less, it's 10,000.
Yung sa CAP, yung 14 days, umaabot sa 1,000 a day. Pero yung 1,000 a day, naibaba kasi nakakuha ng sponsors sa PAPE, sa Fund for Assistance for Private Education. That's their funding agency. But here, as si Dr. Lisander nagsabi, si I think the brothers, because that is part of their charism, will be more than willing to at least help subsidize the program. Since this is really for catechetical work. Although I'm not putting words in the mouth of Brother President. But certainly, don't allow the cost to stop you from getting, I think, you know, Bishop Bobet and the bishop members can do some pencil pushing to bring down the cost. Kasi nga, titira pa rin kayo sa Manila ng 14 days. Eh. Tama? Kung pumunta kayo sa Lasal, the best place where you can stay for 14 days would be Pius. Pius the 12th. So, Pius might be the cheapest place where you can go. And it's also accessible to Lasal. Or we can put it in a retreat house. Kasi pag-retreat house naman, the cost will go up because you have to pay for the lunch. But it is going to be a whole day, ah, hanggang evening yon. Kasi for 6 units, we have to satisfy check requirements for a 6-unit course. So, paabot yun ng 8 to 6 o'clock siguro. Pero hindi naman yung buro lecture. Processing. Any other regarding that? So we're working at a 10 to 14 day program certificate in catechetical leadership and supervision. Okay. Going, I'll move. Second, I would highly encourage the networking among diocesan catechetical offices. We have at present regional approbations. Northern Luzon, Central Luzon, NCR, Bicol, Southern Tagalog, Visayas, and of course, the Mindanao area, the 5 ecclesiastical jurisdictions, as I mentioned yesterday. And we would want to encourage you to work closely for your own programming because I think you know the situation of the region for you to easily address the concerns of the region with regards to catechetical instruction. The other one is, we propose this, the state of religious education or catechesis in the country. It has been some years since we have the National Catechetical Survey, at least for us to feel the pulse of where our people are. So if we say there are around 80 to 90 million Catholics, where are they? But it should also be a survey based on the TWG's discussion last night. A survey not simply focusing on schools, where catechists are with regard to schools, but also where are our out-of-school youth and adults? Are they catechized? And what are the forms of catechesis that they experience, both at the parish level and on the PEC level? In other words, the survey will be done hopefully in the next months or so. What we are requesting, fathers, is your cooperation for the dissemination of the instrument of the survey. We will be requesting, the University of Santo Tomas Social Research Center to help us do the research, since they have the know-how and they have the resources for this. This will be of great help for us because this will enable us to see how we can project catechesis in the new millennium. So that is part of our program. Mother Ernie.
Yeah, Father, the catechetical mentors indeed will be of vital help for this. But the first question is, where are the catechetical mentors? It seems to me that is this compulsory for catechetical directors to attend this scheme, or it's just somehow sad that more dioceses, catechetical directors are not or simply not serious with this.
At the end of the day, that is what we call freedom of choice. CBCP LJ, as well as the other commissions on the CBCP level, cannot make impositions on dioceses. We were told a number of times by CBCP. The reason is because it's still the bishop that tells his priests where the commitment lies. Letters are being sent by the bishop chairman to the bishop. It's up to the bishop to pick it up or not. It's his choice. You're a case in point. You got the letter, the bishop receives the letter, he tells you, you attend that, you attend. But we cannot tell the bishop that you must send your priest. We're forbidden to do that. That's against the ecclesial framework, because the bishop is only answerable to Rome, to the Holy Father. So what we can only do is by means of persuasion, not imposition. You send the letters, you nga, pati survey naman eh. You send the survey, if a diocese does not want to fill up the survey won't be completed and would never really provide a good macro reality of catechesis. We can only do as much. That is why I am requesting mobilize the catechetical offices through the regions, Northern Luzon, Central Luzon, Southern Tagalog, Bicol, Visayas, and Mindanao. Nasa sa inyo po iyon. Hanggang doon lang kami. At least, ngayon nakikita ng trabaho. We help. People pick it up, thank you. People don't pick it up, I can't do anything. Any comments regarding that? The other one is this, number four, is a proposed organization. And the proposed organization is the National Association of Catechists in the Philippines. At the end of the day, what we need to cultivate is that a catechist can be a member of a professional organization, even if that catechist is a volunteer catechist. So that catechist would have a sense of belonging to a national organization that would provide training and networking and advocacy on his or her behalf. And possibly, at the end of the tunnel, also provide assistance, financial or whatever, to these catechists. That's precisely, Fathers, the purpose of PhilCare, the Philippine Catechetical and Release Education Foundation. The purpose of that is that eventually, if the money is big enough, it would be able to help remunerate catechists in poor dioceses financially. But at present, the funds are not even enough to sustain our office. Now, with regards to the National Association of Catechists, we are proposing that be aware of it. It could be announced. Now, who can be members of this? It could be priests, it could be religious, it could be lay. And of course, there will be minimum membership fee, annual membership fee. Because if you're a member of an organization, you really provide or give a membership fee. I don't know yet the fee. I'm just mentioning this to you. It's very raw. There are no... Sorry. It's there in front of you. Can you look at your folders, the proposed, and may I request, it's from Dr. Pilar, no? Father Dex and Dr. Pilar, can you say a few words regarding this, the concept paper, for initiating a movement? You.
Yes, actually one of the many meetings that we had, the technical working group, Monsignor Jerry, we were mulling over the idea of organizing the catechists. Not simply because we want to organize them, but because we see benefits to it. And what could be some of the benefits? You know, our catechists need a very strong support group. We know that the kind of work that they do, the kind of work that they do would need also constant training, sustained development. So one of the key principles in this association is that we shall be providing our catechists with sustained development, okay, through seminars, workshops, and also assemblies. So that's one of the things that we are going to do. Now, the national association will not only address the need for training, but also the need to sustain the spirituality that catechists should have. We know for a fact that in the kind of work that they do, they also need to have the kind of spirituality that will see them through the difficult tasks that they are doing. Okay, so continued formation, sustained professional development, spirituality, and also we want to introduce our catechists into the realm of research and communication, because we know that research is a vital tool for us to be able to know the community we are serving. So we are also going to assist them along that line. Also, just like what Monsi said, that the support community that would provide the catechists with a strong backing or support in terms of the work that they are doing, and also in terms of advocacy. So these are some of the few points that we have considered in this national association. There will be a yearly gathering of catechists for training, for celebration, for spirituality. So basically, that's what we are envisioning. This is the first time that we are organizing such an association. And we deem that it will truly be beneficial for our catechists.
Questions? Comments? I think everybody is still
digesting
all of this data, processing them in their mind.
Since we also would want to strengthen the synergy between catechists and ministers, youth ministers in the diocese or campus ministers, we are including youth ministers as associate members of the association. Kasi gusto nga po namin yung synergy na yung ma-establish between the catechists and the youth ministers. So you will see there that they will also be accepted as associate members and other pastoral workers in the local church. So it will not solely be limited to catechists.
Okay. Thank you, Doctora. The next one is the certification of catechetical centers. The documents are there in front of you. We're going to hopefully have some pilot the testing of the instrument with, as mentioned yesterday, 3 catechetical centers in Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. But for the record, this has been in the offing for the past 4 years now, and it hasn't really been launched, precisely because the instrument has been has to be refined and finalized, and of course submitted to the bishops for their initial approval in principle. So kindly be aware of the certification program. The other one is the NCDP. There has been a question why NCDP is out of print. No? Reason is because the original soft copy has been infected by virus. No? So we are now hopefully finalizing it and requesting it be printed under the auspices of ECHE. So kindly just inform your catechetical centers and coordinators that we are on top of this. The other one is Skip 2017. Have you made up your mind at least? Because if this body has approved where to go next year, would it be here in the Philippines or abroad? And if abroad, the choices are Thailand, Korea, Australia, New Zealand. So kindly choose. I think Korea, some of us can go to North Korea. For exposure, exposure program, and for martyrdom. Okay. Or you want to have an encounter with the ISIS of Syria, that will be straight to beatification. These are what we call beautiful options. Pros and cons. Eh, Holy Land. Ang costing, wala pa, syempre, kasi ano. Pero, Father Ernie, you said, I think the Diocese of Malacca went to Holy Land. Can you say something, please?
We just had a good number of clergy with our bishop went to, not Holy Land, this gift that it's supposed to be. But bishop chose instead Rome. So we just had that last September, and we took Voyager travel from Makati, and they did a pretty well good job from assisting the police sa visa, and then the mga services inclusion sa trip. I recommend. That's Voyager travel from Salcedo. Well, of course, it will always depend on the number of passengers, among others. Lagi namang ganun. So unless we have the number, hindi sila makakapagbigay siguro ng quotation. At least siguro, parang basta magbigay lang ng number. Gano'n naman ang mga travel agents.
ginamit din ito ng PNS noong nag 50th anniversary ang PNS, nag Holy Land tour din. Thank you.
Good 30 packs.
We will ask.
You ask now.
Di naman po ako.
Wala pang range. Mukha kasi na travel agent eh. Ito lang travel agent na. Sanay ka eh. Any questions regarding that one? Pagpasok mo na tayo sa discussion. Saan ang feel ninyo? Kasi right, last year, remember, we were in Vietnam? So this year, local. Ang napag-usapan last year, every other year, ang labas ng bansa. Okay? What is your feel? If we go, for instance, to Korea, then South Korea, we will go to the catechetical offices, of course, as part of the exposure.
Are there
Dominican sisters in Korea? They have many friends. The Philippine ambassador to South Korea is a friend of mother.
Wow! Let's go.
Yeah, he's an ex-priest.
Mentor.
So, he would be... Okay. Saan ang feel ninyo? Usapan nyo nga muna, fathers. Para ano? Kasi I think we get directions from you where we would go. Pwede naman local. Where in local?
Korea
local. Father Timex? Yes?
Korea.
Korea daw. Ano nga tayo, show of hands? Oh, Father, you have a question.
Just to give you an idea about the finances of Holy Land, because the diocese source of God.
Microphone.
The diocese of source of God is planning to have our retreat in Holy Land. And we conducted, I just forgot the travel agency. We are going to Israel, Jordan, and Egypt, and it costs us $2,850.
How many days?
15 days. $2,850 for 30 participants.
Oh, pero yung food, Father?
All in.
All in, breakfast, lunch, dinner?
Yes. All in. All in, pati yung mga dito, from pizza, and all the taxes, it's all in.
That's 2,000, except pocket
money. $2,850.
Dollars.
And then we have side trip in Dubai, additional $490. Dubai, Abu Dhabi, additional 3 days.
Wala sa Turkey?
Wala po.
Basta Holy Land na?
Holy, Egypt, Jordan, and Israel. That's $2,850. Clean veg sharing. And then, additional sa Dubai and Abu Dhabi, $490. I'll try to recall the travel agency. Just keep my mind.
Thank you, Father. So there you have it. So, approximately is 2,800. Do you have other places that are not there? Holy Land, Korea, Australia. Let's have a show of hands. Next year, those of you who would want to have the skip here, raise your hand. Philippines. Okay, 1, 2, okay, 2, 3. Those who would want to have it outside the Philippines, raise your hand.
Yeah.
Okay. at extra labas. Next. Let's vote na. Let's vote. Pakikilang sister Dr. Pilar. Those who are open, open mo na. Holy Land, raise your hand, please. Pakikilang. Holy Land. So, ilan yan? 11. Those who have a feel for Korea. Yung mga yan, nakarating na sa Holy Land. Alam ko na tayo. Those who are open to Australia, New Zealand. Okay, tatlo. So we will have 3 venues next year. So ang pinakamataas ay Korea. So we work on South Korea.
North.
Bishop Bobet will lead us to the north. North Korea. Anyway. So, we'll work on North Korea, for Korea, but then South Korea for next year. Thank you.
Mas cheaper.
Mas cheaper siguro yan.
Subsidized.
Ang mangyari ngayon, kung Korea, what is your take, please, fathers? Let's finalize the dates. April 24 is the week after Easter week. Usually, skip happens a week after Easter week. Will we be there for 4 days?
No.
4 days, 3 nights?
No.
Okay ba? 5 days, 4 nights? Okay. Taas ng kamay. Those who would want or would want 4 days, 3 nights, raise your hand. 4 days, 3 nights. Pakibilang. 4 days, 3 nights. The shorter, the cheaper eh. Diba? 24. Those who are in favor of 5 days, 4 nights.
5 nights and 4 days.
9. 9.
Dalawa
dito. Dalawa. 11. Okay, 11. So how many? 24
and
11. 24 and 11. So, actually those who would want to stay there longer, you can stay there now for another day. But the conference is only 4 days, 3 nights. Okay ba yun? 4 days, 3 nights, input as well as going around.
Exposure.
Exposure to the mountains. Korea. Okay?
Promo.
Promo.
Promo rate.
Promo. Amis? Promo rate na tayo sa mga pakpak.
Yes.
Wawal.
Polis na polis. Polis na polis.
April 24 to 28. April 24 to 28. Those who would want to have more time there, then we can make arrangements with the hotel where we will be staying.
Go hotel.
Go hotel.
4 nights.
4 nights, 3 days.
Yeah.
4 days, 3 nights. 24.
Five days, four nights.
We'll make some arrangements. final schedule, Mother, to get in touch with Davao is August 16 to 18.
3 days.
AMCM. 2016 po yan, ha? This year, ha? August 16 to 18. Can you mark your calendar? Inform your respective coordinators. This is for catechetical directors and coordinators. Okay. We would want now to show you the CD. These are the modules for the Year of Mercy, Eucharist, and the Family. That all, everything is contained in the CD. So I just want to show you the content. We will peruse the CD. So the title is On Bended Knees, it's a facilitator's manual. We were able to inform Bishop Garcera as well as Archbishop Palma because they are the ones in charge of the two other celebrations, Family and Eucharistic Congress, respectively. That is the table of contents. There are three modules. Thank you, Lapuhe. Can we turn off the lights? We printed the CBCP pastoral exhortation for the Jubilee of Mercy and the Year of the Eucharist and the Family. So we printed the pastoral exhortation, and then you have there the orientation. The movement is reflective exercise and pastoral statements. Actually, one module can be extracted. We can extract around 3 or 4 conferences or encounters. Very good. So that's the introductory module. And then you have module 1. Module 1 is on mercy. Focus is on mercy. There's a workshop. Actually, please take note, this is not for children. It's really adult catechesis. It is adult catechesis. So, kindly look. You can pakinakihan siguro noel. Yan. So, ang movement ay we do the prayer, we have the reflection, pastoral statement, and reflection workshop. You have the integration, and living the Jubilee of Mercy. The module two, is on the Family. That's the Family. We've also printed the different important documents. The theological text from the 51st International Eucharistic Congress. And module 3 is Family. So there are 3 modules. Next. The appendix. Okay. So, next. That is the CBCP pastoral. So, it's there in the city. the CPP, CPC. May copy ang kayo dyan. Kasi that will be the topic of Father De Guzman. That's the message of our Bishop Chairman, Bishop Magliari. And then the foreword from Sister Lydia. Thanks. And even the schedule is provided, how to go about the whole thing. Thanks. So that's the sample schedule, how to go about that conference. Thanks. Ang mga modules kasi should follow the tripod from CBCP, which is celebration, formation, legacy. Celebration, formation, legacy. That's the tripod.